episode 364. Welcome back, my friends. A couple of years ago, I would not have been able to talk about the topic of today's episode. I had a handful of friends from years ago, mostly spread around the world, and I rarely speak to them. Then, a few acquaintances, former work colleagues, people I know at the gym, and that was about it. I didn't know how to make friends. I thought they magically arrive somehow. That special person you meet on a plane and have an immediate connection with. Or some other unlikely scenario. I had the wrong perceptions of friends. The few I have are good friends. Friends that know a lot about me. Friends that I can talk to all night long and never run out of topics. Friendships that can be silent for years and can be picked up again with one phone call or visit as if nothing had happened. Yes, those friendships are special, and they are rare, and I believed these are the only friendships worth having. Everything else is a waste of time. So I treated every human that crossed my path and that didn't appear to be that magical connection at first sight in accordance with that belief. I didn't give them a chance. I didn't waste my time with them. I didn't invest into those people. I had better things to do. And as a result, I was often alone. Because even the best friends have lives outside of your friendship with them. And then I discovered Meetup. When I couldn't find one I liked, I created my own. I named it after my podcast and thought that it would be a good way to keep the conversation about Quest for You going. 10 to 12 people gathering over dinner and engaging in conversations. Nothing more and nothing less. Yet, it has taught me invaluable lessons about friendships. Friends do not have to be perfect. You don't marry them or live with them. They don't need to be aligned with your beliefs, your taste of music, or your age. Sometimes you will only share one thing in common. For some of my Meetup friends, it's simply that one dinner once a month. For my climbing partner, it's only the climbing. We don't do anything else outside of climbing together. You may not be able to talk about your deepest secrets with some of them, but you may still enjoy your time together over something you both are passionate about. Maybe it's a person that likes to read or take photographs, just like you. And all you ever do together is talk about books or go on photo shoots. Maybe you try to do other things and it didn't work. It's okay. Don't look for the perfect friend. Look for a friend that helps you grow, even if that is just in one area of your life. It is better than being alone. Random contacts can turn into friendships. You just have to try and give those people a chance. One of my dinner members turned into a friend. After several dinners with the group, we discovered that we shared a common passion for personal growth and helping others find their best life. So we met for coffee once outside of the dinners with the group. This quickly turned into regular meetings where we talk about more than just self-help stuff and how we're doing in our endeavors. He listens to my podcasts, I attend his workshops, and we talk about our personal lives. We became friends. I tried the same with a few others from the meetup, met over coffee or went to some events. It didn't work out with some of them, but you always have to try, because you never know. A couple of days before Christmas, I randomly invited a few members from my Toastmasters group over for Sunday brunch. I was house-sitting again at my friend's and had a big open kitchen available, which is perfect for hosting. I've shared with you previously how wonderful the people in the Toastmasters group are. And we all know so much of each other's lives from the speeches that we have shared. The brunch was the first time we shared time together outside of the meeting. And it was amazing. Everyone felt so comfortable with each other, which led to some of them sharing even more very personal stories. Sometimes you have to give a little more of yourself at first. Not afraid to share and be vulnerable. Maybe pick up the first coffee bill or invite people over. or sacrifice some of your time that you had planned to do something else with. I recently made a new friend at a gym. I'm always highly focused during my workouts. I don't chit-chat. I put my music on or a podcast and I go. I don't have much time. I have to get home afterwards and work on my podcast. And I also have not been much interested in the people that work out there. Yes, I probably judged them. I didn't think I have much in common with any of them. But here you go. I spend a few minutes more talking with someone and a few minutes less lifting weights, and I ended up making a friend. A great person that turns out to have very much in common with me. Taking the first step is not easy, but it's also not that hard. Sometimes all it takes is walking over to a person and sharing a few words. People are hesitant. They don't like to approach. They play it safe. So it is on you to overcome the first hurdle. And I believe I'm able to do it today because of my meetup that I started over a year ago. And here is the best part. Some people stay random and casual connections that you only see from time to time. Others turn into friendships. Maybe you even find a partner this way. But, and even better, these loose connections all have you in common. And there may be times where you connect them. A dinner where you invite someone from another group. A class you take that one of your friends also wants to join. Suddenly, you are connecting people. Maybe they are not your best friends, but maybe they find a best friend in each other. Maybe they find a business connection, someone to coach them or give them a job. This, my friends, is what it means to build a tribe, to add people to your life of all colors, people that love who you are, that are inspired by you, that like what you do and want to learn from you, or that simply enjoy your presence. Loose connections, random links, infrequent contacts, and then to connect some of them so they can continue growing their tribe. Sometimes I just sit there and watch them go. Talk and laugh, find out they grew up in the same city or worked for the same company. They exchange phone numbers and I later learn about their ventures together. Sometimes I sit there and I don't get to say much. I just watch. And it feels great to see people connect. I haven't read this anywhere. I haven't studied it and nobody told me about it. I told you, I didn't know how to make friends. I simply discovered it. And I discovered it only when I took the first step. When I took a chance. I did something risky and uncomfortable. I simply went with my intuition. And I do it again and again. I hosted a Thanksgiving dinner with strangers. This led to connections that I already saw again. And you can do it too. You can build your tribe. If you find yourself in need of friends or simply people to share your passions with, then go out and find them. It may take a little while, but it will happen. You heard my story. I didn't do anything uncommon or extraordinary. I simply show up as myself, not hiding anything, not pretending to be anyone else. I am just who I am, and I open up a little bit. That's all. Try it. Give it a chance. I encourage you. Much love.